dress. So we are here right now at the Braves game. So this is a start of a new vlog right now. We're on our way right now to this game. So let's go ahead and get inside. Yeah, so we are on our way in right now, waiting for Tony. You want to say what's up, Tony?
Huh? Bro, that is fucking crazy.
Hey. Hey guys, so
my name is Eric.
We're here at the Braves Stadium. We're about to watch the Braves against the finals of the Braves against the Miami Marlins. So we're excited.
Oh yeah, so this is definitely going to be exciting, I should say. So yeah, we're waiting to go inside right now. We're just here in the parking lot right now. So they're doing some fireworks. You guys can see it right now in the background. But anyway, we about to go ahead and go inside. So it's now September the 12th, and yesterday I had a really, really good time. Believe it or not, that was actually my first time, like, ever. I'm at a baseball game, and I had such a good time. But It's now September the 12th, and I'm actually getting ready to go ahead and film a quick video. I need to go ahead and post up a look for my birthday, which is actually tomorrow, and I want to do this quick video. So I'm going to go ahead and quickly record that, and then I'm going to go ahead and shoot some content and have my content ready for tomorrow, which is actually my birthday. So you guys are pretty much just seeing me right now working on the wig and trying to get this content together for this wig. So let's tune into this. All right. So let's go ahead and install this wig. So I went ahead and I cornrowed my hair straight back. It was about 6 braids. I went ahead and I just cornrowed going straight back. And now you're just going to go in with your Lace Paste Go Glueless Spray. And I'm going to go ahead and use that spray to spray it on my edges just to go ahead and make sure that none of my natural hair get into the cap itself and it doesn't show once I go ahead and put the wig on. And good thing about this spray that it doesn't have any alcohol in it, so you don't have to worry about it irritating your skin or causing you to lose any of your edges. And I just went in with this brown stocking cap, and I would definitely advise you using a stocking cap that's as close to your skin tone as possible. And you're just going to go ahead and follow that with your Go Glueless Spray. Spray the cap on just around the edges, around your hairline. And just follow it using your blow dryer. And one of the things that I like to do when anytime I'm installing a cap, I like to go ahead and use the back of a rat tail comb. And I like to go ahead and just press that in and just allow that to melt even more, just so it can be as flat as possible. And once you go ahead and cut off the remaining, the excess piece of the cap, some of the piece may not be melted completely, but all you're going to do is just go right in with your Go Glueless Spray and spray that, and then just use the blow dryer and continue to melt it. Like I was saying before, once you go ahead and cut off that extra piece right in the front, that band right in front of your stocking cap, some parts of the lace may not be melted completely. So all you have to do is just go in with your Go Glueless Spray and just spray it right on to wherever you need to go ahead and melt. And then just go right in with your blow dryer. And that's pretty much it. And now it's time for the fun part. And right now we're going to go ahead and start styling this unit. And right now I'm just applying the smooth serum, and that's going to add moisture back into this unit, because you guys know sometimes blonde hair can be a little bit dry. And so we're just going to go ahead and add some smooth serum into the unit. And then we're just going to go ahead and make sure that you guys work that completely through the hair to make sure that you add moisture into this blonde unit all the way through. And once we're done with that, then we're going to go ahead and apply the heat protectant spray. And when I'm applying the heat protectant spray, I like to do it two ways. Sometimes I apply it section by section, or sometimes you can apply it all over the unit as you're styling. It just all depends on your preference. But we're going to go ahead and apply that heat protectant spray. And then once we've applied the heat protectant spray, we're going to work that in. And then you're going to go ahead and apply your standout flexible styling spray, just to make sure that you lock in that well, actually not curl, because we're not curling it, but we're flat ironing it, but it just helps the hair to lay better. And because it's flexible, that means that the hair is going to move and it's not going to be stiff. So that is definitely a great thing. And the current flat iron that I'm using is the Babyliss Pro Nano Titanium Flat Iron. And one thing I would say to you guys is, when you're buying flat irons and curling irons or any sort of hot styling tool, make sure that it goes up to 450 when you're working with these wigs and extensions. Make sure that it goes up to 450. I was actually trying to crop him out as much as I possibly could, but that's actually my son in the background, so you guys don't mind him. He's just in here trying to keep me a little bit company. That's all. Are looking for a good curling iron that really holds curls, like this H2 Pro is honestly one of my favorite curling irons, one of my new favorite curling irons, I should say. There's a few, and I'll go ahead and share a couple with you guys in some other videos, but this one, this curling iron right here, is amazing. And what I'm doing right now is I'm just curling the bob like this, the unit like this, because I just want to make sure I have some sort of layers going on right in the very back of this unit. And you guys will see once I'm done how the back is going to look. But make sure that you guys are using curling irons or any sort of hot styling tools that goes up to 450 degrees. That's very important. So make sure you guys are looking for tools that goes up to 450 degrees when you are buying your tools. Now right here at the crown, you're going to go in with your FHI curling iron, and because we're getting ready, you know, it's pretty much in the bang area. That whole section is pretty much the bang. I'm getting ready to go ahead and do a side bang. I usually like to start like right there by the crown, like right there at the back. I start going ahead and using that curling iron to go ahead and create those curls, just so you can go ahead and see the layers. Now I'm getting closer towards the front, and now it's time to go on with your lace paste sleek it lock stick, just to make sure that front part is flat. And I'll go ahead and also add the exact flat iron, the exact hot comb that I used to, in order for me to go ahead and do this. And that honestly just makes so much of a difference when you go ahead and do this. Now look at this back. And I know sometimes people are so afraid to use product in blonde hair and just product in the wigs and hair in general, but you guys see this? And if a lot of you work with blonde hair, you guys know exactly how dry and blonde hair can be. But just look at this. And I'll go ahead and I'll do a step by step in the description and everything that I added step by step. But this is exactly what you want. Thank you. So I literally just got back to the house and I am just loving this heat, y'all. Like, this is everything. I just need to go back now and touch up my wig and finish doing this video for Instagram and finish shooting these pictures to post tomorrow. Oh, this is so cute. So I'm just gonna go ahead and finish with this wig so I can go ahead and post. I'm just playing with it a little bit just to see how I want it to lay. But this is just everything. I haven't done a blonde look in a long time, so I'm just loving this look. Let me know what you guys think about this look. And you guys saw I installed it, but the camera died halfway through. And, Jesus. And that's just the worst thing that could happen. But anyway, we're just going to make this do what it do. But I still, you know, I still have so much more wigs to install. So you guys will be able to see how I pretty much install my wig. So we're only just getting started. So stay tuned, y'all. And anyway, you guys are going to see me finish fixing and working with this wig. So, yeah. This is the outfit. I probably may need to go ahead and tape my boobs.
Oh yeah, that's sticking right there. But,
oh Jesus. Alright, so this is the dress. So this is the dress. I had this maybe for about, I've had this now for about a year. I got this from Pretty Little Thing. But I need to go ahead and take off this bra and tape up my boobs. But I'm not sure how that's gonna look. But we're gonna see. Let me get the shoes. Hold on. These are the shoes. Can you even see the shoes? Can you even see the shoes? No, can't see the shoes. Oh yes, this is cute. I lost a little bit of weight too. This was tighter than this. Let me see the purse. No, this don't go with this. You got a little purse to go with this thing. Can I see something? This should go. Really, no purse at all. Something like that. Maybe I'm gonna take it in a little too. Yeah, but this dress is everything. Everything. And I think this is a 1X. I was going to rock it with these purse, but I don't think this match. Yeah, this doesn't match. But I don't really have anything else to go with this. So I'm going to figure out and see. I need to put on like some baby oil and all up my legs. You know, it had... One thing I love about stuff like this is you can cover, you know, the little belly. And I do have on a girdle underneath. But like a short girdle. Yeah, so that's the good thing about it. And you see it has these things right here. You can literally, like, you know, match it onto your skin and just roll it on down. Yeah, and this is it. Alright, so I'm about to go ahead and take some pictures. And so this is pretty much my birthday look. So this is my first get ready with me. And I'm just going to tape up my boobs. And hopefully that'll, you know, give me something. Because, yeah, a bra is not going to do it. And that's pretty much it for this look. Let me know what you guys think. And again, I got these shoes from Shoe Dazzle. The dress from Pretty Little Thing. And I just have on some pearl earrings. And you guys saw how I installed this wig. And that is pretty much this look. So make sure you guys like, subscribe. I'll put up some content here showing you guys how it look once I put, once I go to take pictures. But yeah, thank you guys so much for tuning in. And make sure you guys like, subscribe, and share. And I'll see you guys in the next one.